to the press conference for Ultimate Glory on the 14th of March. Another fantastic Goodwin event coming up. I can't believe you just keep putting these cars together to do this. It's just another absolutely amazing five car. Really, really excited. So let me turn you over to our promoter for the evening, Mr. Steve Goodwin.
Well, welcome, thanks for coming to the Grand Hotel in Trafalgar Square. It's an honour for me to be presenting the press conference here, and this is quite an apt car because it's our fifth anniversary since I came into boxing and started promoting. 5 years ago, myself and my family walking around the streets of Milton Keynes putting flyers through people's letterboxes, trying to put a boxing show together, knowing nobody from boxing, with four fights on in Milton Keynes Football Stadium. It was very difficult, and the first 6 months I wondered why we even started to do it. But now when you look back 5 years, I feel honoured that we've managed to achieve what we have, and it's absolutely fantastic. Just a bit of background to what actually happened with us. I came to boxing, done the first show, and I was then asked to look after a fighter called Yassine El Machi. Now at the time, I wasn't able to have a promoter's license. I worked with a friend of mine, James Paisley. And after about 18 months, I got Yassine El Machi to 19 in the world. How I managed to do it, God only knows, because I didn't know as much as I know now, but I still managed to do that for him. And unfortunately, Yassine suffered an injury and didn't fight again after. I then looked after Ali Adams, and I brought over Audley Harrison from America and staged Audley Harrison Ali Adams fight at the Brentwood Centre in Essex. And I think that was the time when people started to take it a bit seriously, that we would do things out of the ordinary. The problem with sport hall promoting was and still is that boxers are given a pile of tickets, they're told to turn up on the day, they're told to pay the money in, and that's all the help they get. We try to do more than that, and I thought there was a gap in the market to try and look after these guys properly, build them properly, and try and actually help help their careers with people that are going to do it with integrity and honesty. And I'm really proud that we've been able to do that. We've got a big team of people that have helped us do that, too many to mention, and without them we wouldn't be here today. The first wife I actually managed is sitting here at the table, Lee Markham. And I took Lee on when he was 3-1. He's now 13-1 going for an English title. So that means something very special to me that on our fifth anniversary, Lee Markham is headlining the bill, alongside Larry Dyer. We're now the second biggest manager in the country of boxers behind Steve Wood, according to the BBBFC. And I only actually was able to get my manager's license 2 years ago. And I promised my wife that I'd only manage seven boxers. I tried to keep my promises, but when I got to number seven and then the eighth come, you think, well, if I don't do it, I think somebody else won't do it as well. So it carried on, and we're now into the 60s. You can't manage 60 boxers alone, it's impossible. People that try to do it can't do it properly, so I've assembled a fantastic team around me. I've got my son Josh, who works full-time in the boxing, he does a fantastic job for only 19 years of age. My daughter Olivia's fantastic, she does a brilliant job. And the most recent addition is Kevin Campion, who came down to Leighton Buzzard last September, moved in with his family. And he's been unbelievable, and he's helped the business grow in massive strides only in the 5 months he's been here. And without all of these people and plenty of others, you know, we wouldn't be able to achieve what we have done. Enough about us, but what we will be doing ongoing is not only will we be taking on more boxes because we can, and we can do it properly, we've got the infrastructure to do it, we'll also be building our infrastructure and our team. And as time goes on, we'll be recruiting more people to work with us. We want to get good people in boxing, and we want to make a difference, and we'll be able to do that. And I hope that the next 5 years will grow as quickly as we have in the first 5, and then I think things are going to be great. This card is unbelievable. It's the best card I think we've staged in depth. We've got some fantastic fights on the bill, and it's going to be a very, very exciting night of boxing. We've got the four big title fights. We've got Lee Markham against Jermaine Smile, and I'd like to thank Jermaine for coming down from Leicester to this press conference today. It's really good of him to come with his coach, Chris Plyer. We've got Larry Ekundayo, who takes on Dale Evans in a British title with him later. And when I say thanks to people, there's a lot of people behind the scenes who make things happen. And behind Larry Ekundayo is a fantastic man called Ben Gray from World Class Athletes. Without Ben Gray, lots of people wouldn't have for Larry, and Larry knows that as well. Ben Gray is an absolute pleasure to deal with, and he's a credit to the sport of boxing, and he deserves everything that he gets. We've got Johnny Garton, who I took over last October, and I promised him a Southern Area title shot, and we delivered that for him in 2 months. He beat Adam Battle, and now he has his first defence against Nathan Weiss on the 14th of March. Nathan's not here, but Johnny is. I believe there's only one winner in the fight, and the winner's here.
We've also got Leon McKenzie in his first title fight. Now, Leon's story is unbelievable. If you haven't read his book, I suggest you go out and buy it. It's an inspiration. And this man is someone that inspires me. And there's not many people in this world that inspire me anymore, but Leon McKenzie is one of those. And I wish him every success on the 14th, and I pray and hope he wins and wins his first title. Finally, one of my favourite boxers to watch, who's fighting, Smoking Joe Mullender. Joe Mullender is never in a boring fight. He's taking on a Latvian KO artist called Eduard Gerasimovs, who's won six fights with six knockouts, and he's promising to knock out Joe inside 2 rounds. He's got lots to say for himself, and I hope that Joe delivers the business. I want to introduce the rest of the table that I haven't mentioned already. We'll start from the far right. On the far right is a flyweight who I believe will send shockwaves through boxing in the next 2 or 3 years. He may be a little hard to handle at times, but he's going to be exciting to watch. I think he's got the talent to go the whole way, and people like Charlie Edwards better watch out. His name's Prince Patel, and that should tell you everything in its own right. He's going to be stylish, entertaining, and he's got a lot to say. I'm sure we'll hear a bit through the future press conference. Next to him is a cruiserweight that I think could be an absolute star of the division over the next few years. His name is Jose Lopez. For those that don't know him, you will know him soon. He's 2 from 2. He's exciting in the ring. Don Charles waits for him as the next baby hay, and that's no mean feat. And I believe that people such as Isaac Chamberlain and people like that are out there are pretenders, because when Jose gets them, eventually he will surpass them. It's a big statement, but I believe that's going to happen. As I say, we've all introduced Joe. We thank Joe for coming and Larry. And Leah, Johnny, and Leon. At the far left is a chap that nobody will know yet, but he's going to be exciting to watch. He's trained by a man called John Cole, who has been a very good friend to me since we started in boxing. He has, in boxing, you meet people when you start. Some people, they come and go because they're not the people that, to be honest, you want to associate with, but there are plenty of very good people in boxing, and John Cole nobody knows about, and I hope one day that his talent gets the recognition it deserves. Because he's a trainer that can go all the way and train champions, and I believe that he will do that. He's got Diego Berton, who's not fighting on these shows, and he's transformed him. Louis Darling has had 35 unlicensed fights, 35 wins with 31 knockouts. John Cole's taken this walk in as a project, and the signs, I could not believe Louis did. I've seen two stone like I've ever seen before. I think Louis will be a really exciting heavyweight, and I'm absolutely delighted to have him on board. I'd like to thank everybody here, and I'd like to pass over now to Brett to do some questions.
Alright, we're going to start. We're going to start down here on the left, so you can pass the mic down to Prince Patel. Right, guys, I've been